Good day, fellow investors. A thing that is often overlooked is a possibility of an inflationary crash. If we look at the stock market now, yes, it looks extremely overvalued. The stock market is just going up and up and out. It has no relation to fundamentals, but this reflects also the value of money. It's not that stock prices, assets, real estate, that the value is going up that much. It's that the perceived value of money is going down. And that's why in our series, I really want to discuss an inflationary crash today. Because if you look at the stock market, this is 80 years of data from 1925 to 2005, then you can see that, yes, everything, stocks, this is logarithmic scale, stocks continually go up with ups and downs, of course. But if we adjust for inflation and we look at the nominal return, then for real value, I think the rate is $10,000 became just $33,000 if we adjust for inflation. That's the real value created by the stock market. And that's also a risk and reward. The businesses give you protection from inflation in the long term. And that's one of the, or even perhaps the most important reason to have investment exposure. So that's a positive, and that also justifies these levels, because if we have more inflation ahead, we might see the S&P 500 at 8,000 points. And if we look at Professor Macquarie's data, I'll put the link in the description below, very nice report. Since 1928, dividends plus inflation accounted for 99.7% of the nominal wealth produced until 2008 by investing in stocks. This is really, really incredible and something to think about. And this is why I think value investing works extremely well, because yes, you get this, you get that, but then you are looking for the earnings for the businesses that can give you an additional boost here. If not, you are practically playing the game and feeling good, but not understanding that it's all about inflation and dividends. And Football Dreamer here says, nobody believes this rally since day one, all artificial. People want to know when it will end. That's it, because they click on crash videos. And I said, maybe, never. Maybe the stock market will just keep going up. You think it's impossible? Let me show you this. If we look at the Argentinian stock market, the Merval index, so it was low, 200, 300 points, and then in 2015 it already started exploding, and simply as the peso dropped, it went from, I think it was 1,000 points here in 2000, and then it simply exploded to 66,000. And you can see, despite the situation in Argentina, the stock market went up, so at least people got some kind of protection from devaluation of currencies. And as we can see, all the currencies are made to be devalued. So that's something each of us has to keep in mind to own assets. You never know when we'll have an inflationary crash. We had one in 1970s. You never know how it will impact businesses. And therefore, I love value investing, because I'm looking at, okay, worst case scenario, am I doing good? Sometimes 10 years I will not do great, I will do just good, but the next 10 years I will do amazing, and that will cover up for the 10 years where I do so. That's a risk I accept, because I don't know the future, and that's also the beauty of investing, of building something over time, looking at the risk and reward, not getting wiped out, compounding over time. There will be good periods, 7 years, 7 good years, 7 bad years, and that's something we have to accept. Focus on lowering risk by buying quality businesses, and that's about it. Maybe we'll have inflationary tailwinds, maybe deflationary headwinds, but if we focus on businesses of quality, whatever happens, we'll do well. That's the key when it comes to invest. Also, when it comes to the stock market, you must not think it's overvalued, it's undervalued, it will crash. I've been listening to crash predictions since 2010, and Well, those that predicted in 2010, we are 3x, 4x, 4x, the S&P 500 is 4x. Imagine those that sold here, and I know a few, sold here, said the stock market will crash, will go back to 700 points, 666, I think it was the low in March 2009, and that's insane. So think about the value you own, subscribe to this channel to find the best value, and I'll see you in the next video.